Welcome to this video playing Onkel Yodok from Germany. Very high rated. He doesn't have a name in there, but it's a very high rating. And I'm not quite sure who Onkel Yodok is. I need to Google that. If this Onkel obviously is the uncle. What am I playing here actually? I wanted to play this Kalashnikov. Okay, then let's go for the Shveshnikov. I have an old line here, Bishop e6 that I played years ago. Yeah, I need to Google that. Maybe that's some character from a movie or a book or something. Yodok is not a regular kind of name. Okay, so this is the idea. Taking on d6 is very risky now. Though I forgot what's the best reply is. It is risky. This much I know. Knight b6, yeah, is the normal move, and now rook b8. Knight d5, queen d8. This is a line that I have had studied years ago to have some alternative in the Sicilian that is not not too far explored. I vaguely remember that bishop g5 and then g6 and f5 is the way to play. Yeah, it is interesting. The interesting positional feature about this position, of course, are the knights. They are nicely positioned. At least from an optical point of view, they look nice on b6 and d5, but it's not so clear what they're doing. They're not attacking much. Ah, see, he's trying to regroup. So I'm going for this f5 counterplay as usual. If he goes knight e3, I just while thinking about some positional features, he just took this pawn. Wow, I didn't see that coming, obviously. Great. So, is there some way to at least get some play out of this? Maybe with the threat d8 d2 I can get something here. This pin is a bit awkward. Yeah, he's just grabbing all kinds of stuff that I'm obviously leaving hanging. But this is maybe this move. I didn't see that beforehand, but I can take b7. I'm not seeing much in this game. So, I can just take and play bishop c4. It's two pawns, right? Yeah, it's two pawns. For zip and pip, I have absolutely no compensation. can try to get a bishop to c3. Yeah. Yeah, I know you're going to play e6 even. Yeah, it's just busted. Yeah, it's no use. Come on.
Black resigns.
Yeah. Knight d6. Yeah, it's not even good. After knight e7, I'm fine. The comp says at least. Oh, b5 with the black advantage. b5. Yeah, sort of trapping the knight. Intending. What? King g7 and bishop e7 now. Okay, no one's going to see that. Yeah. I just need to play king h8 or something and get rid of this stupid trick. And then it's just a normal position. Just king h8 or something. So. After the taking here. So I didn't, what? I didn't see any of the good moves and I took, so. And now queen c7 probably. Yeah, I didn't see this one. And this he probably didn't see beforehand, but it wasn't the problem. White is just winning here. Yeah, a good game by him, not much. What you can say. I mean, okay, it's just a theoretical thing that this kind of move like knight e7 is actually good for black, or b5. Who is going to see that in a blitz game? B5. Yeah, actually considered it briefly, but I thought that maybe I can do something with the pin, but I overlooked bishop a6. Yeah, this isn't it just takes away all the squares. Yeah, but no way I'm going to do that. All right, thanks for watching.